morning, everyone.
Good morning, teacher.
How are you?
Good morning, teacher.
Thank you.
How are you?
I hope you all are safe from the coronavirus.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you happy?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, now, children, now we are going to start the next exercise 2.1. This is page number 25. And question number 1 is find the cube root of minus 1, 8, minus 27, and 64. First of all, what is the step? How can we solve this question? We just take minus 1 by taking the cube root. The value of cube root is 1 over 3. Okay? The value of cube root is 1 over 3. It is a radical form and it is an exponential form. So in this question, we solve by the exponential form 1 over 3. And we suppose this value is equal to s. Right? Next step. How can we solve this question? Because we find the value of cube root by taking the cube on both sides. This cube cancels with 1 over 3. So x cube is equal to minus 1. Students, here in the right side, we don't have the value of 0. We have the value is minus 1. So if I change minus 1 the direction, it will change the sign also. Like this. X cube plus 1 is equal to 0. What is the next step? If I'm taking the cube on the 1, so 1 is never be changed with the other number. If I'm taking the cube of 1, it will never change. But we can use the formula of cube. That is why I'm using the cube on 1 in the next step. And we have already studied the formula of cube. A cube plus B cube is equal to A plus B and A squared minus AB plus B squared. This is the formula of cube which we are using to solve this question. Here, x cube represents the A cube and 1 cube represents the B cube. So, here we use the formula in this question. When I am applying the formula on this step, x plus 1 means a plus b. Next is a squared means x squared. Using the sign of minus and the value of a means x, the value of b means 1, and then square of b means 1 square is equal to 0.
Excuse me, miss. Yes, and please write the formula on the top, then it would be easier for us to understand.
Okay.
Thank you, miss.
Welcome. So, dear student, I am using this formula on this step. Right? What is the next step? We can see there are the two brackets. First of all, we just change into single bracket. X squared means x squared. When multiply with x with 1, their answer is x. 1 square means 1. So here, in the next step, we change two bracket into single bracket. In this step, there are the two factors of x, but these two factors are equal to 0. What is the next step? I just changed these factors separately, equal to 0, because we just find the cube root. In a simple way, we just find out the value of x. X is the supposed number. We don't know what is the value of x. Here, it's a linear equation. What is the linear equation? Can you tell me what is the linear equation? Yes, student. Linear equation means the power of variable is 1. Okay? The power of variable is 1. Where is the variable? Variable is the x. What is the variable? What is the variable? Variable in the maths, the alpha bits we are using the maths are called the variable. So x is the variable and its power is 1, which is not mentioned, but we have to know there is no power, it means its power is 1. So here is the power is 1 and is the variable is x. It means this equation is called the linear equation. Okay, this equation is called the linear equation. And from the linear equation, we just find out the value of x. It is very easy. To just remove the numbers, we just return with the x to other side. 1 is added with the x. When I change the position, the sign will also be changed. So, the value of x is minus 1. I find only 1 cube root. Now, another factor. X square minus x plus 1 is equal to 0. Which type of equation? In the other factor, this equation is called the quadratic equation. What is the name? Quadratic equation. What is the definition of quadratic equation? Why I am saying this equation is a quadratic equation? Quadratic equation means the variable power must be 2. The variable power must be 2. Okay? If the variable power, highest variable power is 2 is given in the equation, we can say this equation is called the quadratic equation. This equation is called the quadratic equation because the power of x is 2. The power of x is 2. The power of x is 1 is called the quadratic or linear. Tell me the answer.
Linear.
It's a linear or quadratic?
Linear.
It's a linear. Why? Because, okay, yes, because its power is
1.
Because its power is
1.
And its power is 2. If the power of the variable is 2, this type of equation is called the quadratic equation. Which name is?
Quadratic
equation. Okay, tell me, why I am saying this equation, this is also equation. What is the reason why I am saying it is an equation?
Because of equality sign.
Very nice. Because the equality sign, if the equality sign is present in the algebraic expression, it is an algebraic expression. Algebraic expression means the symbols and the variables are combined together. So this combination is called the algebraic expression. And if the equality sign is also present, so this algebraic expression is called the equation, right? Now, in the quadratic equation, we just find out the value of x. We have the three methods which we have studied in the chapter number 1. How can we solve the quadratic equation? And their methods name are, you can solve this question by factorization. You can solve this question by completing square. And the last, you can solve this question by quadratic formula. But there are some reasons, some conditions, which method is used to solve this equation. Okay? But now here, it's our previous lecture. I am not repeating the previous lecture to solve this question. I am just few points given to solve this question. I will solve this question, I will solve the equation by using the quadratic formula. What is the quadratic formula? I am just writing on the formula which already studied in the chapter number 1. Okay? I think so it's exercise 1.2. X is equal to minus b plus minus square root b square minus 4ac over 2a. This is the quadratic formula which we have already studied in chapter number 1, exercise 1.2, and we are also using in the exercise 1.3 or 1.4, depends upon the condition, right? So here, B, A, C, you have already know what is the meaning of B, A, C. From this equation, the value of A is the coefficient of x square, and here, x square, the coefficient of x square is 1. B is the coefficient of x, and here in this equation we have the coefficient of x is minus 1. And next, C is the constant number, and from this equation, which number is the constant?
1.
Why I am saying 1 is the constant?